Christmas with both feet. Black Friday has come and gone, the weather has turned cold, their decorations are all up, the parties are starting, Christmas music is playing, tis the season to be jolly. When we think of a season like this, we think family, we think giving. So many good and wonderful things rush to the forefront of our minds. But you know what's funny to me, though? In many of the conversations that I have with different people, there's a subtext, there's an undertone. Occasionally people will voice it, but a lot of times they don't. They may say things like, "Tis the season to be jolly," or "Tis the season to be joyful." But really what they're feeling is a lot of pain and loss. Maybe they say, "Tis the season for family," when really what they mean is, "Tis the season for conflict." Christmas can be a painful reminder, for instance, that you're struggling financially. It can bring added chaos to life that's already razor thin in its margins. You may use Christmassy ways to describe it with words like hustle and bustle, but really what we mean is stress and anxiety. Tis the season. But you know, I'm not sure that the pace and quality of Christmas in our society is going to slow down or become less busy. In fact, it seems to be advancing more and more every year. So this leads me to a very natural question. How do we make it through a life like this one? So much pain, so much disappointment, so much worry. How do we make it? You know, I think of the story of Joseph. He's found out that his fiancée, Mary, is pregnant. She has this crazy explanation for it. He's embarrassed. He feels shamed and disappointed. And just when he's about to give up, God sends a messenger his way. This messenger is an angel who says, "Do not be afraid. Take Mary as your wife. For the child within her is conceived by the Holy Spirit, and she will have a son, and you're going to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." Then Matthew, the gospel writer who wrote this, reminds his readers that this was a fulfillment of a promise that God had made hundreds of years before. A man named Isaiah said that a virgin will conceive a child, she will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God is with us. You know, the only way to make it through the chaos and the pain and the disappointment and the frustration that life can bring sometimes is to realize that Jesus came to save us from our own chaos and pain in order that we might be with him. One of my favorite descriptions of Jesus actually comes from a man named Dick Foth. He describes the story of Jesus in this way. He says it this way. He says, "He came from his place to come to our place, to take our place, so that we could go back to his place with him." No matter how far away you think you are, no matter how bad it's gotten, no matter how stale life seems to feel, God loves you so much, and he wants to be with you. Jesus came to save us from our mistakes, from our selfishness, our hurts, our pains, our sins. We just have to admit that we made those wrong choices, accept the forgiveness that he offers, and follow him with our whole lives. Do you know that your life can change in this very moment? You can ask God to forgive you of your past failures and make a commitment today to make him the center of your life. All you have to do is ask. If you need prayer or you have questions about starting a new life with Christ, please contact us. You can contact us by phone or through our website at auroranewlife.com. But today I want to assure you of this. You are not alone. God loves you so much, and so do we. So from our family at New Life to yours, we want to wish you a Merry Christmas, and God bless you.